story. We have a story of a man that they call Hamabeth. Hamabeth, they call him the widow's son. He was a master builder. Now, we should be able to bring this right on in. He was a master builder, they say, at Solomon's temple. He was one of the chief builders. He was there with two others, Solomon and Hiram, king of Tyre. And they say that Solomon called the men to help him build the building. But the word Hiram was his name. And Abith means father or leader. Abu. So he was the leader amongst the craftsmen. And they went about building the temple. We should go about building the temple. The temple within. The temple of our life. The temple of society. And one day, they say while he was going to make noon prayer, or door prayer, as we call it, he was approached by three men. Jews, they call them. J-U-W-E-S. Jubilee. Jubilee and Jubilee. They say there was a word that was split up between King Solomon, Hiram, King of Tyre, and Hiram and Bill. Don't just think of the word, think of knowledge, wisdom, the ability to build your life, the ability to erect the temple of your being on the proper square of truth and justice. For us to build it on the two things that the Prophet Muhammad left for us, the Quran and the Sunnah. He said, I leave with you two things. And he said, whoever sticks to this will never go astray. So nevertheless, he was gone. And he's saying, at one gate he was approached by Jubilee. And he said, give me the word. Give me the knowledge. He said, I cannot. For you must wait to the completion of the temple. And what did he say? He said, no, he could not wait. He was anxious for it. He was impatient. So he struck him in the left breast. And it says he stumbled and he ran to another gate. And there he met Jubilee, as they call him. And he said, give me the word. He said, I cannot, for the temple is not complete. So he struck him in the throat. And he stumbled and he ran to the final gate. And he met Jubilee, who struck him in the head and killed him. Now, how do we see this? Before we go any further, they said that Jesus was pierced in the side. They said it gave him the vinegar as he was on the cross. And they said it gave a crown of thorns on his head. Three places. When they brought us here to America, England, France, and America, did not they hit us in our left breast? Did not they try to rip out our heart and make us cold and insensitive to one another? Cut off the natural connection between the heart and the brain. The jugular vein feeds the brain, which represents a connection between the heart and the brain. It represents a connection between the intelligence and the emotions. They cut it off. So now we become excessively emotional. Run, run, run. Everything is pop your finger and come to us with any sob story and we go with it. What else did they do to us? They hit us in our throat, meaning what? They stripped us of our language. They stripped us not only of our language, but our ability to articulate, our ability to teach and to preach and to talk the word of truth and to teach the knowledge that was in our head. But they hit us in our head. So they stripped us of our language, of our knowledge. And what else? They hit us in our head. They robbed us of our culture. They robbed us of our religion. We practice this all. There in Africa, Mali, Timbuktu, Ghana. We were Muslims before we come here. A great, great percentage of us were Muslims. They robbed us of our culture, robbed us of our language, robbed us of our natural connection to the great book, Al-Quran, Kareem. They took away from us those sacred principles that will make a man be upright, that will indeed raise a man from a dead level to a living perpendicular. They took that from us and made us tap dancing, shoe shining cowards. mean? What is the rubbish? You're a nigger. You ain't no good. It represents those things that will make us feel inferior. Then they threw them in the grave. They brought them to the West and put them in the grave, and they planted a little axial plant there. And he laid in the grave 15 days. What is the 15 days? It only represents he was hit 3 times. So it represents the 5 senses. See, we evolve mentally, morally, spiritually. So we have senses, 5 senses here in our sensory body. But it evolved to a rational level also, right? When we say, do you see what I'm saying? Do you understand? Do you hear me? Not do you hear with my ears. Do you hear with your mind? But then it moves to a third level, a sort of intuitive sense. So there's a 3 levels. And what happened to Prophet Muhammad? He received 5 ayats. But Gabriel gripped him how many times? He gripped him once. He said, read. He said, I cannot read. He gripped him again. Read. I cannot read. He gripped him again. He said, read in the name of Allah. And he began to read. So he laid in the grave 15 days. Doesn't mean 15 days. It meant that his sensory body, his rational body, and his spiritual mind, that they had attempted to kill him in that. And that is what has happened to us. But what happened? They tried to raise him. Not 2 times. 3 times. They say Jesus rose on the 3rd day. Days represents night, represents light, which means understanding and knowledge. So he raised, they tried to raise him. Oh, so much that I have to skip over. So they say when he went to raise him, that they hit him on the 1st mountain, which I didn't get a chance to tell you, means Boaz. Boaz means strength. Then he hit him on the next mountain, which was Jason, which represents establishment. And it represents together a promise that God made to David that he would establish his kingdom and strength. Then he finally raised him with the lion's paw. Solomon finally raised him. What does this tell us? You couldn't raise the people with just strength. You can't just come with, I'm going to build an army. We just need strength and fortitude to raise the people. It might shake them a little bit. But they ain't gonna raise them up right. Then you can't just come to them with establishment. You can't just come to them with governmental established programs. You can't just come to them with just institutions of learning or welfare programs. No, you can't just do that. You have to come to him with a full program. You have to reach his senses. You have to reach his mind and raise him from what? From a dead level. A horizontal level to an upright position. And what was we raised on? The Honorable Elijah Muhammad, may Allah forgive him his sins and ground in paradise. Even before him, Farad Muhammad came with strength. He said, the white man is devil, you a god. Some strong stuff. Some strong talk. What did that do? It shook us up a little bit. It didn't raise us from the grave. It gave us some ideas and it shook us up. Then the Honorable Elijah Muhammad came and establish schools of learning, establish institutions. But that didn't raise us. It gave us some motivation. It gave us some courage, some incentive. But what has raised us? If we bear witness, we will bear witness that as they are raised on the 5 pillars or on the 5 points of fellowship, there was the 5 pillars of Islam that has raised us up. We are raised up on the 5 pillars of Islam. It is La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. It is the 5 prayers that really raise us up. So if we relate that, we can see that what happened? He was raised on the 5 points of fellowship, which alludes to the 5 senses. And it was a word, a substitute word, they whispered in his ear called Mahabon. And Mahabon has several meanings. But one of the meanings, in addition to representing 3 men, is marrow in the bone. And marrow in the bone is associated with mercy in the bone, or mercy in the heart. And they say, threw their hands up and said, was there any, O God, my Lord, was there no help for the widow's son? O God, God, my Lord, I fear that the master's word is forever lost. Mahabon, was there any mercy in these people's heart to kill the master builder like this? Were there any mercy in their heart to kill the ancient builders of the pyramid like this? To kill the ancient builders of the Sphinx? To kill the people who brought geometry to the world, trigonometry, chemistry to the world? Was there any mercy in their heart to strip these people of what they had like this? Was there any mercy in their heart? So they thought, Mahabon, was there any mercy in their heart? Maybe there was no mercy in their heart. But we believe that Allah, as it says in the Quran, is the beneficent and the mercy. And we know that Allah showed mercy and bring to us the Quran and bring to us our religion of our Islam and bring to us some wisdom and bring to us some light and some understanding. And we pray to Allah that we can continue in our efforts, our good efforts, and we can grow more into light, into wisdom, and into understanding. And on that, I'd like to greet you in peace. Assalamu alaikum, and may we can return.
And it is telling us that these rays tell us that we should not be able to see, but we